On today's Maker Mashup quick tip, we are turning up the speed on our 3D prints. Welcome makers, on today's Maker Mashup, we are going to be turning up the speed on our 3D prints. Now that doesn't mean we're just gonna be turning the knob on the front of our printer, turning it all the way up to however high it will go.
What we do is if we need that extra push over the cliff, you know what we do?
Put it up to 11.
11, exactly.
We're gonna be taking a much better approach to it than turning that knob on the front of the screen, but that knob is really key to understanding how we can get our 3D prints to print faster. Now, there are a lot of different tricks that you can use to get your prints to print faster. Some of those tricks include using thicker infill, not using infill at all. But what we're going to be doing today is addressing one of the things that take the longest amount of time with your 3D print, and that is where you're printing many different top and bottom layers. For me, that's always been a frustration. I can literally turn the knob up on the front of the printer and have it print faster, but then I've got to come back later on and turn that back down after it's printing. I have a volcano nozzle, and it's not always appropriate to have everything cranked up on your printer. There's delicate areas of a 3D print where you need to have it move slower and other areas where it needs to move quickly. And we recently had a question in the Discord where someone was having a very similar type of problem where they needed to move slower and they needed better adhesion for a particular 3D print, but then the rest of the print could be at a normal speed. And that's really hard to do with some of the settings in your slicer. So what we're going to be doing today is I'm going to be showing you how we can adjust that dynamically inside of Cura, but if you're not using Cura, the same technique can be used for Prusa Slicer or Simplify 3D. You just have to modify the G-code afterwards. So with all that said, let's get to work. Here we have three identical prints. The only difference is the one on the left took 20 minutes to print with default slicer settings, and by making some speed adjustments on the other two, I was able to get this down to 13 minutes, a savings of 7 minutes on such a small 3D print. Here we are inside of Cura, and what I've got here is a print that I put together for this video specifically, and I printed this at 100% infill. Now, when you look at this here, we have a few things to note. We've got our first layer here, which is going to get our adhesion to the bed. Then we've got a number of solid infill layers that will fill all the way up to the top of the surface. And then we've got some detail, these little rods that come up, and then we have a rough on top of that. Now, when you look at this overall, the first inclination of most new 3D printer users is that they want to crank up the value for all of this type of layer work, which is the top and bottom setting. Now, Cura does only print this at 30 millimeters a second by default. So if you change this to 120, you certainly will get much faster printing. And I was able to shave off a good three, four minutes of time just by changing that setting alone. However, that is not always appropriate when you get to other parts of your print. So when we get up here, we may not want to print this at a 4x speed because it could end up knocking one of these pins off or causing some other issues with the print. So Cura doesn't really give you a good way out of the box to be able to control the speed in which these different layers print. You can control the top and bottom speed, but it's very difficult to control individual layer speed. But there are some settings in Cura that you can use that post-process the print and enable that functionality. So the way that I approach this is I get a good baseline print. And in this particular case, the default settings work just fine. Then what I'm going to do is change each individual layer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be using a plugin for post-processing inside of Cura. So you go to processing and you modify G-code, and then we're going to add a change at height script. And this enables you to pick different layers, and at the end of this layer, it will apply these settings below. So what we're going to do is, because we want to print those lower layers at 4x the speed, we're going to put 400 in here, and everything on those layers is now going to be set to 400%. So as if I turned the knob up on the front of the 3D printer till it read 400. Now there are two settings here. Keep value means that it will set the setting and keep printing. Single layer means it applies only to the single layer. So in most cases, we're going to want to use keep value. Now, once we've got that done, I'm going to close this out, and then we're going to look for our next layer that we want to change our speed at. So right here, after layer 13, so right at layer 13, we want to change our speed again. Now, because this is detail work, I may have a scenario where I'm getting poor layer adhesion, or maybe it's detailed and I need to be able to print slower. So if we change the layer number here and we put this at layer 13, we can then change our speed and adjust this to something that might give us better print results. Let's say 80%. Now we'll close this again, and of course we're leaving keep value on. So now the printer's gonna be printing at 80% of nominal speed. When we get to the top here, and after we print this layer here, which will nicely create a nice bridge there, we want to change our speed again. Now, we don't want to do that at a full 400%, but let's say we want to print it slightly faster. So we're going to go in here, we'll change our layer number, and we'll set that to 47. And then what we'll do is we'll change our speed here, and we'll change this speed to 200%. So it will still print twice as fast as normal, which would be the same as changing this top bottom speed to 60. Now, something to note as well is that not only does this change the speed of the layers for your top and bottom speed, but it's also going to increase your wall speed and it will increase your infill speed. So everything on these layers is now going to be printing at 200%. So now that we've made those adjustments, let's take a look at the G-code, because not everybody has this plugin or uses Cura, but you can insert the same G-code into your 3D print regardless of your slicer. So we're going to save this, and then we're going to go take a look at it on the inside. All right, so here we are inside of our G-code file, and I'm going to be looking for layer colon, which is the comment that's put in for each individual layer. And as you can see here, we've got our layer 0 and then layer 1. This is the layer that we wanted to print, and then after we print it, we want to change our speed. So if we search one more time and we go to layer 2, if you look just a little bit up, you'll see there's that change at plugin, and you can see it executed an M220 command and set that value to 400 or 400%. Now, this is where you can make the same change in your G-code anywhere, even without this plugin. You just need an editor like Notepad++ or Sublime. There's a number of different editors. Pick your favorite, and you can load this file up. So if you sliced it with Prusa Slicer, or you sliced it with Simplify 3D, you can still go in here and add this M220 command and set it to S400. Now, if we look for this change at, you can see that here we are at layer 13. So layer 14 is going to be our next layer, and it sets it to 80%. And then if we look here, layer 47, layer 48 is our next one, and then that would set it to 200. So with this, we set three different regions of our print with different speed settings, completely independent of how the slicer is going to print each of those different types of 3D print moves. So now that we have this all done, let's go ahead and print this and see what our results are like. So as you can see, using this feed rate selectively at individual layers can really give you some advantages of printing detail at a slower speed and getting a higher quality there, or you could print other layers fast when you know all you're printing is some surface skin or the base of something and you've already got your first layer attached. So it really allows you to save a lot of time on your 3D printer if you have a high flow nozzle, or what you're printing and how you're printing, your particular nozzle can keep up with the higher speed. So I think this is a great way to adjust your print settings in a different way to give you some granularity that you would not normally get by adjusting the 3D print settings for the entire print overall. So with that, it's gonna bring the end of today's video. If you liked it, make sure you mash that like button and don't forget to share and subscribe so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. I'd also like to give a special shout out to all of my Patreon members. Thank you for your support of this channel and also to our MVPs in the Discord. I also recommend everyone to please check out the Discord. It's a very large makerspace of thousands of makers that really allow you to share ideas and get suggestions for any of the projects that you're working on. And of course, I'm in there as well, and I would love to talk with each of you. So I want to say thanks again for watching, and we'll see y'all next time.